Hello students, how are you? I hope you all are fine. Let's continue with the chapter 4, A Truly Beautiful Mind. In previous part, I explained you till paragraph number 11. Let me tell you the summary of this chapter quickly. This chapter is about the famous scientist Albert Einstein, his life and his achievements. This chapter shows him to be a human being and a fairly ordinary person with his own likes and dislikes. Albert Einstein was born on 14th March 1879 at Ulm City in Germany. From the very beginning, from his childhood, he was different from other children. How? In physical appearance, in other intellect also, his head seemed too large, and so his mother thought he was a freak. He started speaking after the age of 2.5 years, means very late. And his peers, his classmates, called him Brother Boring, so he usually played alone. He was not a very obedient student. So his headmaster once told his father that it wouldn't be matter that he chose as a profession, because he will never make a success at anything. It means he is good for nothing. He learned to play the violin and was a skilled amateur violinist throughout his life. Einstein was a good student but was so stifled by the regimentation in school. Means he likes studies, but he does not like the regimentation, the rules and regulations, the disciplines of school, so that he left it for the good at the age of 15. Einstein got his wish to study in Switzerland and later at a university in Zurich. He was highly gifted in mathematics and physics. Mainly his interest was in physics and mathematics. And he met his first love, Mileva Merrick, in Switzerland only. He had to postpone his marriage to her because his mother did not like that marriage. Why? What was the reason? That Mileva Merrick was older than Einstein, 3 years older. However, they got married in January 1903 and they had 2 sons. Unfortunately, the marriage did not last long and they divorced in 1919. After that, Einstein married his cousin Elsa. Okay, till here I explained you. Now let's start with chapter paragraph number 12. Page number 49. Okay, the last line of 11th paragraph is Einstein married his cousin Elsa the same year. Means in 1919 only he married Elsa, who was his cousin. Now, Einstein's new personal chapter coincided with his rise to world fame. See, what is the new chapter? Personal chapter? His marriage with Elsa coincided, means related, with his rise to world fame in 1915. Rise to world fame. Okay, he started getting fame with his marriage only. Okay, same thing happened together. In 1915, he had published his general theory of relativity, which provided a new interpretation of gravity. See, time and speed, these two things, okay? These two things relates with each other, okay? This is theory of relativity. One example is also given by Einstein. When you sit with, means when you are doing some interesting work, 2 hours seems like 2 minutes, and when you are getting bored at that time, 2 minutes also seems like 2 hours. Okay, this is relativity. So, in 1915, he had published his general theory of relativity, which provided a new interpretation of gravity. Gravity, you know, gravitational force. Newton explained gravity, okay? An eclipse of the sun in 1919 brought proof that it was accurate. The theory of relativity was accurate, and this was the proof was the eclipse which occurred in 1919. Einstein had correctly calculated in advance the extent to which the light from fixed stars would be deflected through the sun's gravitational field. Einstein in advance only he calculated the extent to which the light of the sun from the fixed stars would be deflected. Deflected means changed direction because of hitting with something. Deflected through the sun's gravitational field. Due to the sun's gravitational field, gravitational area, the light from the fixed stars deflected. The newspapers proclaimed his work as a scientific revolution, and newspapers proclaimed, give the popularity of his work as a scientific revolution. Einstein received the Nobel Prize for Physics in 1921, and in 1921 he got the Nobel Prize for Physics. He was showered with honors and invitations from all over the world and lauded by the press. The press admired highly, and all over the world he was showered with honors and invitations. He became very famous in 1921 all around the world because he received the Nobel Prize for Physics after publishing his theory of relativity. Okay, now paragraph number 14 is some little bit related with your social science, with the rise of Nazis. Rise of Nazis in Germany. Okay, for this you have to refer your SS, 9th standard SS textbook. Maybe it is there. I don't know about that, but maybe it is there. In CBSC, NCERT, it is there. Okay, so just check the rise of Nazis in Germany. Then also I am giving you some brief idea. See, as you all know, World War One. First World War was in 1914 to 1918. Okay, 4 years. World War First है वो 1914 में start हुआ था and ended in 1918. Between the Allied countries means France, Russia. Okay, the countries of Russia, then Britain. Okay, then and the other side was Germany and other countries. Okay, then the war started, and till 1917 Germany won all the areas. But when USA joined the allied countries, means USA joined France, Britain, in 1917 in the war, Germany was won. Okay, it means Germany had lost the war. Haar gaye Germany. Okay, at that time, after the World War First, in Germany there was the setup of federal structure and democratic party. Okay, democratic means like us. People, they will vote and select their leaders. Okay, and federal structure means two-tier government like us, state government and central government. Okay, after the World War, Germany, World War First, Germany had seen many downfalls in politics as well as in economic conditions also. After the fluctuations of powers in politics, Nazis came into power in Germany in 1933. and you know the famous Nazi Adolf Hitler. Okay, you know how he ruled over Germany. Okay, I'm not going deep in that politics. Okay, let's come to this chapter. Nazis came to power in Germany in 1933. Nazis, they believed in very strict dictatorship. डिटीरियोरशिप मीन्स एक तरह की गुलामी, लोगों से गुलामी करवाते थे वो लोग. ओके, शूट एट साइट वाले ऑर्डर्स भी देते थे, जो उनकी बात ना माने उनको शूट एट साइट. और वो क्यों था, ये ज्यूज़ और दूसरे जो थे कम्युनिस्ट और नेशनलिस्ट जो भी थी पार्टीज, उनके बीच में कॉन्फ्लिक्ट्स चल रहे थे, उसकी वजह से अडोल्फ हिटलर है, नाजीज हैं, वो अपना पावर बढ़ाते जा रहे थे और लोगों को दिखाना चाहते थे कि नाजीज हैं, उनकी पावर अब जर्मनी पे है. तो बिकॉज ऑफ ऑल दिस थिंग्स देयर वाज अ केओस इन जर्मनी, सो आइंस्टाइन एमिग्रेटेड टू द यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स, यूएस चले गए आइंस्टाइन. फाइव इयर्स लेटर द डिस्कवरी ऑफ न्यूक्लियर फिशन इन बर्लिन हैड अमेरिकन फिजिसिस्ट इन एन अपरोर. फाइव ईयर्स लेटर, आफ्टर फाइव ईयर्स न्यूक्लियर फिशन की जो डिस्कवरी थी बर्लिन में हुई थी, बिकॉज ऑफ दैट अमेरिकन फिजिसिस्ट हैं वो बहुत ही अपसेट थे. मैनी ऑफ देम हैड फ्लेड फ्रॉम फासिज्म जस्ट एज आइंस्टाइन हैड. फासिज्म भी एक एक्सट्रीम ऑथेंटिकेरियन पावर है. ओके, जैसे बहुत सारे रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशंस हैं, बहुत ज़्यादा वो स्ट्रिक्ट रूल्स हैं, एंड आइंस्टाइन डिड नॉट लाइक सच रूल्स. ओके, सो आइंस्टाइन फ्लेड अवे फ्रॉम फासिज्म एंड नाउ दे वर अफ्रेड द नाजीज कुड बिल्ड एंड यूज एन एटॉमिक बॉम्ब. दे वर अफ्रेड दैट द नाजीज कुड बिल्ड एंड यूज एन एटॉमिक बॉम्ब बिकॉज ऑफ ऑल दिस पॉलिटिक्स. They were in the condition. They thought that the Nazis could build and use an atomic bomb. At the urging of a colleague, Einstein wrote a letter to the American President Franklin D. Roosevelt on 2 August 1939, in which he warned. Now, all the people, they were very terrified. And the colleague of Einstein urged him to write a letter to the American President Franklin D. Roosevelt on 2 August 1939, in which Einstein warned a single bomb of this type. Means the whole paragraph is there, some of the words are given. A single bomb of this type means if you develop such kind of bombs and explode it in a port, and if you dropped the bomb in a port, might very well destroy the whole port together with some of the surrounding territory. Means complete destruction would be there if you drop the atomic bomb. His words did not fail to have an effect. Lekin iski koi effect nahi hua. The Americans developed the atomic bomb in a secret project of their own. But the Americans, they developed their atomic bomb in a secret project and dropped it on the Japanese cities of Hiroshima and Nagasaki in August 1945. You all know about this incident. Okay, till the date these two cities of Japan, they are facing problems till date. Aaj bhi ye dono city ke log hain, ye khatarnak jo bomb फेंके गए थे, एटॉमिक बॉम्ब फेंके गए थे, अमेरिका ने फेंके थे हिरोशिमा और नागासाकी पर, उसकी सज़ा अभी तक भुगत रहे हैं. ओके, अभी भी जो बच्चे, जो जनरेशन वहाँ पर अभी भी आ रही है, न्यू जनरेशन, उनमें भी स्किन डिजीज़ हैं और भी सारे बॉडी में डिजीज़ पाए जा रहे हैं ड्यू टू दिस एटॉमिक बॉम्ब. एक्सप्लोजन जो हुआ था बॉम्ब का, उसकी जो रेज निकली थी, यूवी रेज, और जो खतरनाक चीज़ें निकली थी, वो चीज़ें आज भी उन्हें परेशान कर रही हैं. ओके, आइंस्टाइन वॉज डीपली शेकन बाय द एक्सटेंट ऑफ द डिस्ट्रक्शन. इट देर वॉज a lot of destruction because of this bomb blast, bomb explosion in Hiroshima and Nagasaki. And Einstein was deeply shaken by this destruction. This time he wrote a public missive to the United Nations, UN में उन्होंने एक letter लिखा, बहुत ही long और official letter था. In it he proposed the formation of a world government. See, अब तक world government नहीं थी, world government है उसका power होता है कि वो world के जो भी countries हैं उस पर अपना power रख सके. Okay, so he proposed the formation of a world government. Unlike the letter to Roosevelt, this one made no impact. Iski bhi koi asar nahi hui. But over the next decade, Einstein got ever more involved in politics. But next decade, decade means 10 years. Okay, 10 years after 10, in 10 years, Einstein got more involved in politics. Agitating for an end to the arms buildup and using his popularity to campaign for peace and democracy. Agitating means to stop. Okay. Stop the use of arm buildup. Okay. जो arms बनाए, arms and ammunition बना रहे हैं, जो bombs हैं वो बना रहे हैं और भी शस्त्र बना रहे हैं, तो उसको end करने के लिए and using his popularity to campaign for peace and democracy. उन्होंने जो popularity gain की थी after getting the Nobel Prize in physics, he used his popularity to campaign for peace and democracy all over the world. When Einstein died in 1955 at the age of 76, he was celebrated as a visionary and world citizen as much as a scientific genius. It means he was not only the scientific genius, but he is considered as a visionary and world citizen because till death he was thinking about the peace and democracy in the world. Okay, I hope you understood this chapter very well. Some of the points are related with the history. So go through the history chapter related to Germany and the Nazis power, the rise of Nazis power in Germany. Okay. So I hope you will write this summary properly. Now let's start with the exercises. See here. Most of the exercises are related with your understanding of the chapter. So let me give some extra questions to think over. In this chapter, see, first you have to write the paragraph headings. It is for your understanding only, no need to write. Okay, notes I will upload, don't worry about that. The very important thing is that try to write the summary of this chapter. Okay, now come to the question answer, extra question. Okay, I am taking one sentence questions to check your understanding. Okay, the first question is, where did Albert start his degree education? Where did Albert start his degree education? Do you know the answer? Albert started his degree education at the university in Zurich. Okay. Now, second question is, who was Mileva Maric? What did Albert find in the girl? Why he got married to that girl? Mileva Maric was a fellow student and Albert found in her to be a clever creature. Okay. Then A-double-L-Y, what is the meaning of Ellie? Ellie means friendship. Okay,
फ्रेंडशिप. एली मीन्स फ्रेंडशिप. एंड वॉट इज द एंटोनियम ऑफ एली? एंटोनियम ऑफ एली इज ओपोनेंट. ओके, एंटोनियम ऑफ एली इज ओपोनेंट. ओके, देन what work was entrusted to with Albert? Albert was to access the inventions of other people. क्या काम दिया गया था एल्बर्ट को? To access the inventions of other people. Okay. Then, why was Albert's mother against marriage? Why was Albert's mother against marriage of Albert and Mileva? Because Mileva was 3 years older than Albert. What was said by Albert's mother for Mileva? Mother said that Mileva was a book like Albert's. Okay, then some questions I am giving you to think over. How was Einstein a peculiar child? Kyun special child tha Einstein? Because till the age of 2 and a half he could not utter a single word, and he thought differently from others. His interest was in mechanics only, mechanism only, and after seeing his baby sister, he asked his mother, where are her wheels? Okay, this shows that Einstein was a peculiar child. Why did Einstein leave the school for good? Because Einstein did not like the regimentation of school and he wanted to study in the University of Switzerland. How did the headmaster opine about the boy Albert? Means, what are the opinions of the headmaster about the boy Albert? The headmaster opined that it would not matter which profession Albert would choose because he was good for nothing. Next question. Einstein was a gifted violinist. Detail the relevant fact in this regard. See, in this paragraph, in the beginning, in third paragraph, you have seen that Einstein began learning to play the violin at the age of 6 because his mother wanted him to, but later he became the gifted amateur violinist because he maintained the skill throughout his life. Okay. Then, next question is, was Einstein a bad pupil? What will be the answer? No. He was not a bad pupil. He did not like the regimentation of school, okay, but he liked studies. Okay, so Einstein was not a bad pupil. He went to high school in Munich and scored good marks in almost every subject. He started learning violin at the age of 6, means violin also he learned very well. He became a gifted amateur violinist, but he hated the school's regimentation and had often clashed with his teachers. Okay, it is given in fourth paragraph. Why did Einstein wish to continue his education in German speaking Switzerland? Okay, see, it is given in fifth paragraph that Einstein didn't like regimentation widely spread in schools in Germany. In Germany, in schools there was strict regimentation and he felt stifled there, he felt suffocated there. Okay, he wished to continue his education in German speaking Switzerland, means tongue, mother tongue is same, language is same, German speaking Switzerland he wants to study, and which was more liberal city than Munich. After finishing school, he studied at a university in Zurich. Okay, he started his schooling in Munich and studied in the University of Zurich. Then this one is also an important question. It is the question is, why did Einstein call his desk drawer at work the Bureau of Theoretical Physics? Okay, the Bureau of Theoretical Physics. This question is important, note down. See, Einstein got a job as a technical expert in the patent office in Bern. While assessing other people's invention, he was actually developing his own ideas in secret. Okay, and he worked very hard and jokingly called his desk drawer at work the Bureau of Theoretical Physics. ओके सीक्रेटली वो वर्क कर रहे थे और उनके ड्रॉअर में फिजिक्स रिलेटेड, उनकी रिसर्च के रिलेटेड काफ़ी सारी चीज़ें रहती थी. दैट्स वाई ही जोकिंगली कॉल्ड हिज डेस्क ड्रॉअर एट द वर्क द ब्यूरो ऑफ थियोरेटिकल फिजिक्स. ओके नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, इट इज़ ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट रिलेटेड टू हिज पर्सनल लाइफ. वाई डिड आइंस्टाइन्स मैरिज विथ मिलेवा फेल? Before marriage, Einstein was fascinated by Mileva, her intellect. He thought her as his ally against the Philistines. Philistines means the people who do not like art and literature. Okay. But after a few, the couple fell in love. In spite of his mother's objection, mother का objection था, फिर भी वो दोनों ने marriage किए. But after a few years later, the marriage faltered, and Mileva lost her intellectual ambitions, and she became an unhappy wife. And after years of constant fighting, the couple finally divorced in 1990. Okay. Next question, it is also important. Why did newspapers proclaim Einstein's work as a scientific revolution? In 1915, Einstein published his general theory of relativity, and it gave a new interpretation of gravity. An eclipse of the sun in 1919 proved its correctness, means the correctness of the calculation which Einstein gave the world in advance. He had correctly calculated in advance the extent to which the light from fixed stars would be deflected through the sun's gravitational fields. Due to the gravitational force of the sun's surface, how much the fixed stars' light would be deflected. So the newspapers hailed his work as a scientific revolution. Okay, like this, so many questions are there. One more question is there. Why did Einstein emigrate to the United States? Okay, Nazis came to power in Germany in 1933. Okay, 1933 mein Nazis hai wo Germany mein power mein aa gaye the, and they were war mongers, yani bhookhe the yuddh karne ke, ladai karo jeeto bas. Einstein hated all kinds of wars. Use pasand nahi tha, Einstein ko pasand nahi tha wars. He emigrated to the United States, और वो United States चले गए. The discovery of nuclear fission in Berlin in 1938 shook the world. और Berlin में है वो nuclear fission, atomic bomb की discovery चल रही थी, उसकी वजह से जो American scientists थे वो लोग upset हो गए. The Nazis could build and use an atom bomb. Many of the scientists fled from the fascist Germany after it. उनके बाद और भी जर्मनी के जो साइंटिस्ट हैं वो वहाँ से चले गए. सी, वन मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन, हाउ डिड आइंस्टाइन वर्क फॉर वर्ल्ड पीस एंड डेमोक्रेसी? वर्ल्ड पीस एंड डेमोक्रेसी, Einstein was deeply shaken by the extent of destruction caused by the atom bomb in Hiroshima and Nagasaki. And he wrote a public letter to the United Nations and proposed to the formation of a world government. And his letter made no impact and continued agitating for an end to the arms race. But he tried and tried to stop all these things. He campaigned for world peace and democracy. Okay, so like this, so many questions can be formed from the textbook only. Some of the questions I formed and formed the answers like this. You have to make the answers. I explained you how to write the answer in exam. In exam, give 2-3 lines for the chapter name and the author's name and the one line introduction of the author. Okay, then in next 2-3 lines, you will summarize the chapter and according to the question, you will form the answer using the summary. Okay, now one important type of question, rectification of errors. Previously, I uploaded one separate lecture for rectification of errors. I hope you understood what you have to do in this type of question. Okay, so it will be taken from the textbook only. That's why I'm telling you continuously that go through the textbook and all the words in detail, deeply. Try to understand the preposition, article, conjunction, mainly these three things and tenses. Okay, one more thing, whenever you come across the new word, try to find out the words, noun form, verb form, adjective, adverb form from your dictionary. Okay, Oxford Dictionary is best for this work, for this reference. So whenever you will come across such words and if you find the adverb, adjective, noun, verb form from the dictionary, your vocabulary will be rich, will become rich, and you can handle, you can opt this type of question perfectly. Okay, I will upload the notes and one more question I will add, rectification of errors for your practice. Okay, whatever notes I am giving you, it is sample only. Okay, in exam any question can be asked, so don't depend on the notes only. I told you to write the summary whenever the chapter is over. Okay, so I hope today you will write the summary and after that write the notes. Okay, in next lecture I will start with the poem, fourth poem. Till then, bye.